She's a wife, a mother of four, and the First Lady of Maryland with all that that entails. Suffice it to say, Katie O'Malley is a very busy woman. Now, many people call her Mrs. O'Malley, but for 8 hours out of the day, Maryland's First Lady is also referred to as Your Honor.
Yeah, Katie O'Malley is the wife of arguably the most powerful man in the state, but the courtroom, well, that's her domain. 11 News reporter Mindy Becerra has tonight's Commitment 2010 profile.
All rise. The District Court of Maryland is now in session. The Honorable Judge O'Malley presiding.
The courtroom is Katie O'Malley's comfort zone. Maryland's First Lady admits she's much more at ease on the bench than the campaign trail.
Do you like to be in the spotlight or do you?
No. So that's why the judgeship is a great job for me, because I'm not really the one out there like Martin giving too many speeches or, you know, out there putting myself out there that often. People come to my courtroom.
Judge O'Malley, a former prosecutor in Baltimore County, was appointed to a 10-year term in 2001 by then-Governor Paris Glendening. As an associate judge in the First District Court of Baltimore City, Katie considers herself a positive force in often troubled lives.
I like it because I get to deal with people every day, and I feel like I'm a problem solver. I can try and, you know, if they are in the courtroom and found guilty in a criminal case, I can try and, you know, devise a sentence that will help them.
What don't you like about your job?
Putting people in jail. I don't like it, but it's because it's, you know, it's never a pleasant thing to do, to take someone's liberty away.
Once court is adjourned and the robe comes off, several other hats go on. Mom and wife of Maryland's governor.
Katie O'Malley, love of my life.
Catherine Curran met Martin O'Malley in law school. They married in 1990 and have four children. Grace, 19, Tara, 18, Will, 13, and Jack, 8.
And this is my little boy, Jack, and my other little boy, William.
Bill and Jack joined her for this recent appearance at Johns Hopkins Children's Center. Though she eschews the political spotlight, she is no stranger to it, grew up in a family steeped in public service. The Currans are extremely close. The busy working mother of four says she relies on her family members daily.
I'm really fortunate that I have great family support from my parents and my sister who's in Baltimore, and even, you know, my brother Max and his wife. So whenever I need some, you know, can somebody grab this one or that one or whatever, I have great support. And even friends in Annapolis are wonderful.
As for raising a family in the political spotlight, Katie says overall Marylanders have been kind and respectful to the O'Malley children. And when faced with criticism about their father,
it gets them more invigorated. The girls have been great campaigners, really good. And William is just, so I think, a natural at that as well. Jack, I don't know if I can trust him out on the campaign field. I just don't know what's going to come out of his mouth, you know?
Katie is content to do most of her talking from the judge's bench.
I just love having a job. I would never be one of those political wives that just runs around and gives speeches for her husband. I mean, he's great and I love him, but I got my own thing and I would never give that up or surrender that. And I hope that I'm able to kind of be that role model for my girls. If they choose to be stay-at-home moms, that's great. But if they want to have a career and they have the support that I've had, then they can have it, you know.
Mindy Becerra, WBAL, TV 11 News.
So could politics be in the future for Katie O'Malley? Well, Mindy says the First Lady would only be interested in serving as state attorney general. That's the office her father held for 20 years. As for the O'Malley children, Katie says that she would support them in a career in politics 100%. Be sure to tune in tomorrow when we're one-on-one with former First Lady Kendall Ehrlich.